Madagascar. To some, a word more associated with an animated film than a biodiversity hotspot. But Madagascar, the country, is infinitely more complex and inspiring. In the winter of 2013, I was fortunate enough to experience its environment firsthand. Here's what I discovered. Spoiler alert, there are no psychotic penguins. In the Madeira episode, we looked at island ecology as a whole. Today, we'll focus on Madagascar to explore a major threat to island environments, habitat destruction. Located off the east coast of Africa, Madagascar is the fourth largest island in the world. But it wasn't always so isolated. Once part of the supercontinent Gondwanaland, 167 million years ago, it broke away. Madagascar's relative isolation resulted in an evolutionary experiment. The original Gondwanan plants and animals evolved into a diverse array of forms. I say relative isolation because some of the country's most iconic inhabitants, such as lemurs, weren't present originally. The ancestors of lemurs arrived by rafting events, riding on chunks of floating vegetation carried by favourable currents from continental Africa. Even though terrestrial mammals are less likely to reach islands, Madagascar's high mammalian diversity is partially a result of its close proximity to Africa and its relatively large area for an island. In the millions of years since their ancestors first arrived, lemurs evolved into over 100 species and subspecies, all endemic to Madagascar, meaning they are found naturally nowhere else. Today, lemur diversity ranges from the world's smallest primate to the largest lemur, the Indri. But it's not just about lemurs. Madagascar is classed as a global biodiversity hotspot, but it's equally important for its high levels of endemism, a huge number of unique species. Different climatic zones and their associated habitats may have contributed to the evolution of this diversity, including dry tropical forest to the east and rainforest to the west. Let's talk numbers. There are 384 reptile species, 95% of which are endemic, which includes two-thirds of the world's chameleon species. There are also 310 species of bird, over half of which are endemic, including the giant kua. A minimum of 5,800 invertebrate species were listed during a recent review, with 86% being endemic, including the giraffe-necked weevil, scientifically proven to be the most awesome weevil of all. That's not even mentioning plants. Unfortunately, like most biodiversity hotspots, all is not well. Madagascar's main issue is habitat destruction. Rice cultivation and slash-and-burn clearance have combined with more recent mineral extraction and plantation agriculture to eat away at the forest. Only around 17% remains. And yet, in a country where most of the population lives below the poverty line, who can blame them for using their natural resources? However, things looked rosy in 2003 when the government announced plans to triple the country's protected areas. Unfortunately, a military coup in 2009 put this on indefinite hold and led to increased illegal logging, especially for highly prized rosewood and ebony. So, where does this leave Madagascar's biodiversity? Well, numerous non-governmental organisations are working hard to protect the ecosystem. I travelled to the Manabi region to see some of their work. Madagascara Voakaji promotes community-based conservation and the training of Madagascan researchers. This NGO has established a project to help baobab trees, encouraging children in local schools to grow their own. Northeast lies Karindi Forest, home to many endemics, including the giant jumping rat and the narrow-striped mongoose, also known by the much more pleasing name of Buki Buki. The Dural Wildlife Conservation Trust is researching these animals to try better understand their needs and has also established captive breeding programs. Many other organizations and projects across Madagascar are working hard to conserve biodiversity. Will they succeed? It's hard to say. In January 2014, A new president was sworn in after the first election since the coup. Conservationists are hoping political stability will bring an end to illegal logging, allow room for community-based wildlife conservation, and enable ecotourism to flourish. Whether this becomes a reality or not is something no one can truly predict. Cross your fingers. That was my experience of Madagascar. Here's some footage of me being attacked by a carpenter bee. Enjoy!
It's attacking me.